that 100% of the parents, they give in writing that they will offer Salah 5 times. Believe me, we did not know that we could actually pressurize the parents or blackmail them. When the Christian missionaries are blackmailing our Muslim children, our Muslim parents in Bombay, they are paying 5 lakh. That is, I don't know, 5,000 pounds, 10,000 pounds to get admission. And after paying that money as bribe, every day our children are doing shirk. They are saying Jesus Christ, peace be upon him, is God. So when the Christian missionaries can force them to do shirk, why can't we force to do something with this fard? And believe me, we have been very successful. We know it is not allowed by this government and that government, but alhamdulillah, summa alhamdulillah. So, mashallah, even the multimillionaire, he waits for the interview. We tell him the interview will take time. Be prepared at least 4 or 5 hours, and you will be interviewed for about 1.5 to 2 hours. And mashallah, we have a big questionnaire. And we explain to them the concept of the school. And we tell them that the satellite television is a big shaitan. So the cable TV, satellite TV should not be in your house. TV is not haram, but the cable TV, the satellite TV is a big shaitan. And normally we find that we know that in the Western statistics, the average in America, a child sits in front of the TV for approximately 7 hours on average, more time than he spends in school. Even in India, they spend several hours. And what happened, you know, when we say that if you want admission, you remove the cable TV. And mashallah, they have to do it, otherwise no admission. So because they want, they may not be practicing Muslim, but they have that jazbah, they have the iman, they want to put admission in the school. And now it has become a status. Oh, my son got admission into IIS, status. Alhamdulillah. Allah has given us that status. So to get admission means it's the status. I got admission in Islamic International School. I passed the interview. So then we realized that once the cable TV is out, then and it's compulsory that the parents, the mother, should attend every week our Islamic lectures, compulsory, at least once. Father, twice a month, compulsory. If you don't have time, then no admission. So even the parents are being ingrained. It's a package. We are not only training the students, we are even training the parents. We don't want that we train the child and after 13 years, the father says, okay, now go and do business, okay, start giving bribe, etc. So we want to see to it, we don't want to pour water or drugs back. Chances are that 50% we will lose our children. Because finally the parents control them. So we even change the parents. And if we know that the business the parent is doing is not good, we'll tell you, if you put your child, there are some people who have got businesses, maybe they're working in bank. We tell them, working in bank is haram. Maybe your child, once after 4 or 5 years, he will cause you trouble. So see to it, you change your job fast. So knowingly very well, yet they want to put their children in our school. And the point to be noted here is that after a few months, then the husband comes and tells us, you know, my wife, she has stopped watching TV, now she gives me more time. So even the family life improves. We have got stipulated conditions before admission that minimum 20 minutes every day, there should be a family reading of the Quran along with translation. Every day, compulsory. The father should attend twice a month our lectures in which we talk about Islam. The mothers once a week. So in this way, mashallah, even the environment becomes Islamic. Then besides the parent, even the other siblings come, even the grandparents come. So it is rather changing the society. And we found that when we visited the Western schools, I'd gone to South Africa, and I'd gone to one of the best schools in South Africa about 6 years back. I don't want to name the school. The principal of the school told me that, Brother Zakir, we are at the mercy of the parents. We have to force them to come and take admission, though our fees are half than the other private schools, but then they blackmail us. If you tell us too many things, then we'll go to the government school, we'll go to the white school. And he told me, our students in the 8th standard, 9th standard, girls, one evening we went to a hotel and we found our girls wearing mini skirts and shorts and dancing. Imagine, one of the best schools in South Africa. And the parents were called, the parents are blackmailing. If you get too strict, we'll take out our children from here. Here in our school, we blackmail the parents. but natural for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anyway, the school is not a business. We are spending 7,000 rupees per month per child. So what fees we take, we are spending 1,500 rupees per month per child from our own pocket. So it's not a business. Please don't get me wrong. The school, IRF always does everything free. The school is the first thing we are charging money. But even those who are paying full fees, we are subsidizing the fees. So in this way, mashallah, we want to create a new society. And what we feel, that we, most of the organization that start, it's a one-man show. After the person goes away, the whole thing goes down. Most of the Muslim organization, you see, it's a one-man show. That person goes away, the organization falls down. So we see to it that we require backups. At present, mashallah, in a foundation, Islam Research Foundation, we have more than 15 speakers, mashallah, besides myself. And some of them travel in different parts of the world. In, they have been to UK, Singapore, Hong Kong, Malaysia, South Africa, several places, mashallah. And these children, mashallah, they are our future generation. And if you see the annual day that we have, in the annual day when we have skits, normally most of the schools, they have fancy dress where a person, maybe he may dress up like Michael Jackson or may dress up like maybe Sunil Gavaskar or whatever it is. Here, in our concert, mashallah, one person becomes, he imitates Sheikh Sudesh, one like Sheikh Ahmed Didad. You know, in this way, mashallah, we find that the role models of our children, the present age role models for our children, they are not these pop stars and pop singers and film actors. They are like Sheikh Sudesh, like Sheikh Ahmed Didad, Brother Bilal Phillips. So here we find that we should ingrain in our children that what should they become when they grow up. And mashallah, if you see that these children, they are taught public speaking right from junior KG. From the age of 4, they are taught to stand in front of the microphone. And they are taught how to speak on the microphone. Most of our speakers, I'm sorry to say, they don't know public speaking techniques. What should be the distance from the mic? How is the modulation? How it should go up? How it should come down? The gestures, the eye-to-eye contact. See, when a person gives a speech on the stage, the matter he speaks carries only 7% marks. How much? 7%. 93% is presentation skills. How do you modulate? Your gestures, your eye-to-eye contact. That's the reason today, actually I'm handicapped. The sound system is not good. It is like it says, you're sending a warrior to a battlefield without weapons. The thing is that we should be trained that how we should be able to dawah. So children right from the age of 4, they're trained public speaking in English as well as Arabic. So we want that a future generation that they should be trained, alhamdulillah. So this was a vision with which we started the school, not knowing whether we'd be successful or not. Alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has been so much helpful and grateful that we got application from different parts of the world, from different cities in India. We have an application to start the school in Saudi Arabia, in UAE, in Yemen, in UK, in USA, several applications. So far, we have only started one more branch in Chennai. And our criteria are very strict, mashallah. So inshallah, we feel that every few years, we'll open one school so that it will be role model for the others. And since the time is running short and we have to break for Salah, inshallah, I'll be ending my talk. So if anyone has any questions regarding giving education to your children in the Islamic manner, you're most welcome to ask your questions during question and answer time after the Salah. I would like to end my talk with the verse of the glorious Quran, where Allah says in Surah Fusilat, chapter 41, verse number 33, وَمَنْ أَحْسَنُ قَالَ مِمَّنْ دَوَيْلَ اللَّهِ وَعَمِلِ صَلِحَوْا قَالَ إِنَّنِي مِنَ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. Who is better in speech than one who invites to the way of thy Lord, works righteousness, and says that I'm a Muslim. وَآخْرِ دَعْوَانَ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ.
Okay, JazakAllah khair.